Glory to God. Let's go to Romans chapter 3. And we want to look tonight. I was sharing with them in our afternoon class. We're going to go back over these, however long it is, and just share these things that the Lord taught me concerning faith a long time ago. Now, nobody knows it all concerning these things, but we have learned more than we used to know. Two things that really revolutionized my life. The first thing was understanding the integrity of God's Word. That God was a man of His Word, that God and His Word were one, that God's Word was His bond, and that what He said, He fundamentally, practically intended to do it. All right? That He would not have said something He was not already prepared to make happen. The integrity of God's Word. And that's where a lot of people are in the process of discovering the integrity of God's Word. God's Word and His, God and His Word are one. You can't separate them. If God has said it, then it's done. It's the same as completed, because God has integrity. And I had to learn that when people doubt the integrity of God, it's because they doubt their own integrity. Because if, for instance, if I am a person that constantly runs late, I think everybody runs late. Did I hit the right spot there? Amen. If I'm a person that thinks a certain way, I think everybody thinks that way. Amen. I had to learn this. If I am concerned if God will keep His word, there's a chance I won't keep my word. Because I become like the God that I worship. And so I had to learn that God is a person of integrity, that the integrity of God's word is unquestioned. All right? And when I found John 17:17, sanctify them through your word. Your word is truth. And I made that decision. I put my hand on that scripture and said to the Lord, from this day forward, I choose to believe that every word in this book is absolute truth. That changed my life. My life changed. All right? Now, one of the second things that really impacted me was when I found out that faith was a law. Faith was a law. Amen. Now, some people look at faith, you know, they don't really know what faith is. Hallelujah. Well, you got to have faith. Okay, well, how do I have faith? Well, you got to believe. Well, how do I believe? Well, you got to have faith. And they consistently tell you that you have to have something called faith, but yet, how do I procure it? How do I make faith work? Well, here's the thing you got to understand. Faith is a law. Things that are laws, you do not have to make them work. Right? For instance, when you're flying a plane, there's a law of lift and thrust. It works. If you get that plane up to a certain speed and apply the law of lift, by adjusting those flaps or whatever you do, Pastor Tony knows more implicitly than I do, but you adjust the aerodynamics of that wing, you will produce a force called lift. And lift combined with thrust or forward momentum will always move that plane. It's a law. It never changes. Amen. Do you understand that? You know, the law of lift did not come into existence when the Wright brothers flew that first plane. It already existed. They could have flew a plane in the 1500s because the law of lift was already there. Amen. You drove your car here today and exercised something called the law of forward momentum. You got that car moving in the direction you wanted it to go, and you kept the pressure on the accelerator, and isn't it funny? The car kept moving. When you let your foot off the accelerator, it starts slowing down, but it's still moving forward. Because you get that object moving, and it's going to move. It's a law. The law of gravity. You exercise the law every day when you get out of bed. You come under the law of gravity to an experiential standpoint. Your feet hit the floor. You don't roll your legs out of the floor, out of the bed, and you float. They hit the floor because there's a law. You did not have to pray before you went to bed. Say, Lord, please, in the morning, let the law of gravity still be in action. Faith is a law. It always works. It will always work. Amen. I found that out from this tape series right here, Faith, Law of the New Covenant by Charles Capps. This is an old tape series, but it's worth gold to me, because my wife and I saved up $5 to get this tape series. We found a Concepts of Faith magazine in the trash can, in the dumpster outside our apartment. And Kim, I went in the dumpster and got that magazine. Amen. So there's something to be said for that. That magazine was shabby chic. That's what it was. Amen. But we saved up the money. This was on this, and there's another series we saved up for two of them. It's Calling Things That Be Not. That little mini book that we got in, that came from that series. I've got that original series, Calling Things That Be Not. And we saved up the money to get these things. And we would go to sleep listening to this and listen to it. She would be at work. And I'd put it in the tape player and listen to it while she was at work. She worked nights. And he talked how faith was a law. Faith was a law. Well, obviously it wasn't just parroting what Brother Cap said, but it's what brought the revelation to me. That faith is a law. Look at Romans 3:27. Are you with me tonight? Where is boasting then? It is excluded. By what law? Now notice what the Apostle Paul asked. Why, by what law? The law of works? No. By the law of faith. Faith is a law. A law works the same way every time. Faith works the same way every time. Faith comes the same way every time. Faith goes the same way every time. Faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the Word of God. Faith goes by declaring what the Word of God says. Faith works the same way every time. Faith is not complicated. Remember, faith is not sexy. Faith is the work truck. Faith is not a Lamborghini. It's a work truck. Faith gets the job done. All right? Faith is the work truck in the Spirit. It makes things happen. Amen. So it's a law. It works the same way every time, and it always works. Now see, that's what you've got to settle. For faith to be a mainstay, you've got to settle it that my faith, say it with me, my faith, always works.
Always works.
Amen. You got to settle that. My faith always works. Because people will talk about faith failures. I don't believe in faith failures because faith doesn't fail. There may have been something that I was doing where I didn't exercise the law properly, but faith doesn't fail. Why? It's a law. It's the law of the new covenant. The law of the old covenant was what you could do and what you could produce and what you could make happen. The law of the new covenant is the law of faith, which is total trust, total reliance, total belief in what God said alone. That's a law. Amen. And so when I understand that faith is a law and it always works, then I can begin to develop my faith and I can begin to put it on the line in these situations and watch it work every time. Amen. In Hebrews chapter 12, and verse 2, He says, looking unto Jesus, the author or the pioneer, the beginner of our faith, and the finisher or the developer, the one who completes our faith. Looking to Jesus, the beginner, the pioneer, and the developer, or the one who completes our faith. So Jesus is the beginner of this type of faith. He's the pioneer. He's the one we look to as our example for this. And not only that, he's the developer, or the one who brings it to completion. Well, how does that happen? I've got to put my faith on the line. Every day is a faith day. Faith is a tool. Faith is a weapon. Faith is my means of getting into the unseen realm and bringing into my life what I have need of. But it has to be developed. Amen. How do I develop it? By putting it on the line. So you get up every day and you put your faith on the line. Amen. For whatever you're believing for. I don't know what you're believing for, but whatever you're believing for, you get up and you put your faith on the line about that. Okay, I'm believing for debt freedom. Then you get up every day and you put your faith on the line about being free from debt. It's not enough to know that God wants you to be debt free in your case. You got to put your faith on the line about it. Because faith keeps the spiritual pressure on the answer. All right? Faith keeps the spiritual pressure on the answer. Faith is always pushing. As long as you're putting it on the line, faith is pushing. Faith is going to another level. Faith is going into another area. All right? Amen. But I've got to get up every day and put it on the line so what can happen? So Jesus can develop it. So he can complete it. Amen. Faith, I've said this before, is that spiritual organ. It's not an organ, but that's the best analogy. That we contact God with, that we contact the spirit realm with. Well, it's like anything else that requires development. You've got to consistently work at it, putting it on the line. If there's anything that you want to do, if you want to learn another language, you have to work at it. You have to put it on the line every day. I remember being in Spanish classes. We had a wonderful professor, Professor Gonzalez, and he was talking one day, and there was a lady in there, and she just wanted to learn Spanish now. Okay. Not happening. All right? I mean, you're there for... You're in elementary one. I mean, it's the reason it's called elementary one. There's a reason. And she said, but I study every night. And she said this, I study an hour every night and it's not getting any clearer. And professor, he was just, still is such a sweet man. And he would not be mean to anybody. He said, he was from Spain. Used to be a Catholic priest. But got married. Can't be a priest and be married. So anyway. But he loved the fact that we were doing this for ministry. And he told that woman in a very sweet tone, he called her name, and he said, when I first came to this country and I had to learn English, he said, I studied 8 hours every day because I had to learn English. What he was trying to explain to her was, okay, you're saying you're putting an hour into that, but you're not putting it on the line. When you're putting something on the line, it's consistent. You're constantly doing it. Amen. And so if there's an area that you're believing God for, and there is evidently, I've got to consistently put my faith on the line for that. I've got my scriptures, not just a list to have a scripture list, a list that's bringing faith to me. It's producing faith. Right? Amen. If I'm believing for healing, then with his stripes, I am healed. He sent His word and He healed me. He took sickness and disease from my midst. He blesses my bread and my water. He is the Lord that heals me. I'm consistently in ingesting those scriptures, not just to do it, to ingest a certain amount of scriptures. It's producing faith, and then I put faith on the line. Are you clear with this? Amen. Okay, I'm believing I'm healed. And so I'm putting these scriptures in my spirit, and now I'm going to get up in the morning and I'm going to put faith on the line to whatever extent I can. Amen. If I'm having trouble doing something, bending over, moving a limb, breathing, walking, I'm going to get up in the morning, I'm going to put faith on the line in some area, and I'm going to move somewhere. If it didn't but shuffle across the floor and shuffle back to the chair, I'm going to put faith on the line. Right? Faith has to be put on the line to be developed. And if I'm just developing my faith and there's an issue in my body, here's the one thing you can't circumvent. You can't circumvent time. It's going to take a certain amount of time for your faith to be developed to move that thing out of your life. But here's the key. Listen to me. It's a law. It always works. And it always works the same way. I personally believe, you are better off developing your faith to move something out of your life than you are to get an overnight miracle. I really believe that. And I'll tell you why. A lot of people get a miracle and spent no time developing their faith. And here's one thing that I've learned about the enemy. You know, he operates by a law too. It's called the law of sin and death. And I've learned that he always comes for a counterattack. And if I've not built my faith and developed my faith, then I can fall for it. But if I'm up every day and I'm putting my faith on the line, remember what faith is? It's a shield. And it does what? It quenches every fiery dart of the wicked. Now, did it say every? Then it's every. Words mean what they mean. Well, how is that? That person gets up every day and cares for their faith. They get up every day and they put the word in their mouth. They get it in their heart and they get it coming out of their mouth. Faith is coming, and then they're putting it on the line. Then they're putting it on the line. Well, I'm believing to be debt free. How can I put it on the line? Okay, you go down the list and you pick that littlest bill and you say, I'm putting my faith on the line. I'm going to pay this thing off in Jesus' name. And then you sow a seed toward it and you believe God to pay it off. Faith's a law. It always works. And that seed is the point of contact that initiates my faith. You understand that? And then you knock that one off and then you move to the next one. See, you're putting your faith on the line. You're exercising your faith. Amen. Well, I'm believing for my children. Okay, then you get your scriptures about your children and you put them in your heart and you get them coming out of your mouth and then you put your faith on the line. Okay, I'm believing for a turnaround in his life. I'm believing for him to be free from alcohol. I'm believing, whatever you may be believing for, I'm believing for this. And then you keep faith on that. My children will grow up around my table like olive plants. Amen. My children shall be as polished stones in the palace of a king. Amen. My children shall grow up like branches around a water course. One will say that he is the Lord's, and another will call himself by the name of Jacob. Amen. And you keep saying that, and you keep declaring, I did not bring forth children for trouble. Isaiah says, you did not bring forth children for trouble, and this is the heritage of the servants of the Lord. I didn't bring forth children for trouble. I wrote on my list, my children are not troublesome to me and my wife. What am I doing? Am I helping you with this? I'm putting my faith on the line. Yeah, but what do you do when you see something that's not lining up? Faith's a law. It always works. See, it goes back to the integrity of God's word. Did you read that in Romans 3? That faith is a law? Okay, then faith is a law because God said it. So faith is working. Right now, it's working. Why? It's a law. It's a law. There are laws in your body. That you don't try to exercise. When was the last time you tried to breathe? Or had to remind yourself to breathe? Right? It's not like the blonde that used to go get her hair done, had the headphones on. Wait a minute. Michelle, you got blonde hair. Is that real blonde or fake blonde? It's fake blonde? Okay. All right, we're good. You're like, Pastor, you put her on blast. No, it's okay. Real blonde or fake blonde? Fake, we're okay. Jillian is real, but this doesn't apply to Jillian. I'm not going to tell the joke. I'm not dumb. But you remember what they said? They said, don't ever take the headphones off. She told them, don't ever take the headphones off. I take the headphones off, I'll die. One day she fell asleep in the chair. They took the headphones off. Sure enough, she died. They picked up the headphones, and in the headphones it was going, breathe in, breathe out, breathe in. Right? You've never had to remind yourself to breathe. Your lungs know what to do. They filter the air that comes into your body. You breathe in oxygen and you breathe out carbon dioxide. And your body knows you have a built-in catalytic converter. And you don't have to try to make it work. If it's not working properly, it's abnormal. It's a malfunction. Right? But it's yet a law. Faith is working right now. Why? It's a law. But I don't see the results. No, it's a law. See, I want to take you back and show you this. This is the integrity of the word. It doesn't matter what you see. Faith is a law. It's working because God said it was a law. So it's working. The word is working. Say it out loud. The word is working right now in me. Say it. The word is working on my situation. On my children, on my finances, on my health, the word is working. Hallelujah. Now that sounds simple and elementary, but it's what you do every day. Faith is not difficult, it's different. But yet faith requires that you apply a spiritual pressure to that circumstance every day. You have to. Amen. Every day is a faith day. Every day I'm out there stretching my faith to another level. So are you on whatever it may be. Well, I need a raise on my job. Okay, remember the process. Find your scriptures. Put them in your heart. Get them coming out of your mouth. And every day put the pressure on it. Amen. Don't wait for things to change in the natural. Get your check and pronounce abundance over it. Yeah, but what I'm getting is not enough. See, you're going crossways to the law. That's not how the law of faith works. I mean, it does, but it's not working the way you want it to work. The law of faith will either work in for you or against you. It's a law. It's a law. You will have what you say. That is a law that never changes. So you get that check and you declare abundance over that check. I declare I have more than enough. I declare I'm out of debt, my needs are met, I've got plenty more to put in store. I declare I'm a blessing to other people. I declare that I will bless families. I declare that I will buy cars for people. I will buy houses for people. I will help people come out of debt in the name of Jesus. Well, what are you doing? You're putting your faith on the line. And that requires an effort because it requires that you say something that you can't see and that you don't perceive naturally. Amen. But understand, if you say something contrary to the word, to the law, then you are getting highly developed in doubt. You're getting highly developed in unbelief. Because the same process is happening. Amen. Hallelujah. Well, I want a strong this. I want my marriage to be good. It's the same process. It's a law. That's how it works. Oh, glory. So as we put our faith on the line, Jesus develops it. Jesus completes it. And I don't want to move away from that too quick. That's why it's so important to know the integrity of the word. The word said it. So that's what's happening. I don't see it, but the Word said it, so that's what's happening. Did he say goodness and mercy would follow you all the days of your life? Okay, then right now they're following you. Yeah, but there's not a lot of things going on very good. They're following you because the Word says. Amen. Do you see that? Look at 1 John 5. Verse 1. Now notice these words. Now, I know this can sound cliché-ic in a faith church, but listen to me. If you don't have a Bible you can write in, go buy yourself a glass case with some lights and put that Bible in there and put the lights on it, and then go buy yourself one you can write in. Amen. That say this out loud. This is my Bible. This is God speaking to me. That's your Bible. That's God speaking to you. So notice these words. First word you want to look at. Whosoever, that would include you, believes that Jesus Christ, amen, is born of God. Do you believe that? And everyone that loveth him, that begat, loveth him also that is begotten of him. By this we know we love the children of God when we love God and keep his commandments. Now, would that describe you? Okay. For this is the love of God, that we keep his commandments. Notice this. And his commandments are not grievous. Now, stop right there and settle that. His commandments are not grievous. He's not going to ask me to do anything that's going to leave me worse off than when I began. You got to settle that. Forget all that stuff you learned in religious church. Amen? His commandments are not grievous. Buster, would you please show me that in the Amplified Bible, my friend? Thank you. Hallelujah. I want you to see this. I'm taking my time tonight because I want you to see this. And these orders of his are not irksome. Have you ever been irked? Have you ever said that? Oh, it just irks me. Well, what do you mean? Got on my last nerve. Right? Plucking my last nerve. They're not irksome. Oh, here you go. Burdensome, oppressive, or grievous. Settle that. Nothing that God asked me to do is burdensome. It's not oppressive. It's not grievous. Because sometimes when you're talking about faith and putting it on the line, people say, you mean I got to believe for everything? Mm-hmm. And that's the way to get it. That's the way to do it. But his commandments are not burdensome. They're not grievous. They're not oppressive. Now you got to settle that. That brings the joy of doing the word into your life. Amen. You know, religious people say, oh boy, we got to live right. Us faith people say we get to live right. Right? Religious people say, oh boy, you can't have any fun as a Christian. Us faith people say, I haven't had so much fun. Amen? I'm having more fun now than I ever had. Isn't it good to go to bed at night with a peaceful mind? Get up in the morning knowing everything's all right? You don't have to have a shot of this or a toke of this or a drink of this. Amen? You're not dog cussing your wife. She's not throwing a plate at you. Amen. Glory to God. Isn't that great? Amen. You're going to work and you're working hard every day and you're being honest and making an honest living and God's blessing you exceedingly abundantly above all. The word is not oppressive. It's freeing. Yes, I had to learn these things. I had to settle these kind of things. Then notice what he says. Verse 4. For whatsoever, better translation is whosoever. See, that's another one of those words you should circle. Is born of God. Are you born of God? Yes. then look at this next phrase, overcometh the world. Now, wait a minute. Go back to the integrity of God's word. This is a law. Whoever's born of God overcomes. I have an overcoming gene on the inside of me. I'm hardwired to overcome the world. Yeah, but Pastor, you know, it's a little tough. No. I understand it might be a bit of a challenge, but the end result is you overcome. Why? The word says. See, that's got to be your go-to response. How do you know that's going to happen? The word says. Amen. In your mind. I'm not saying you got to say that to everybody else. In your mind, the word says. No, the word says. Amen. The enemy will try to get me to think that somebody's thinking bad about me or thinking ugly thoughts. And I'll just say out loud, nobody thinks that way, dummy. You're a liar. The word says you're a liar. And if you're telling me that, it's a lie. That's a law. So the enemy might say you're not going to make it. The enemy might be pointing you. Listen, I don't know why I'm here again. But listen, 3 years ago, six times, my youngest daughter attempted suicide. Six times. But see, before the first time ever occurred, I had already settled it. Remember what I had settled? Angela is following the plan of God for her life. I'd settled that. Why? Because that's what the Bible said. Amen. Do you hear me? And I could not allow because the law of faith was working. Great shall be the peace of your children. Great shall be the nothing missing, nothing broken of your children. Now what do? Is that the word of God? Integrity of God's word, God cannot lie, that's a law. Great will be the peace of my children. So there were times we'd drop her off at the hospital, admit her into the hospital, and come preach. I wasn't not telling anybody because I was afraid of what people would think. What I said was what the law said, not what the lie said. Amen. And she'd do a little better and come home, and I'd set her down and I'd say, Angela, you are following the plan of God for your life. You are going to do great things for God. Listen, girl, there's so much potential on the inside of you. And she'd cry and say, Daddy, I know it. And in 3 weeks, she'd be dumb again. Amen. Now, I'm telling you this for a reason. We had to stick with the law of faith. See, you can walk through things by faith. And people say, how in the world are you making it? I never knew anything was going on. Right, because the pressure's on the word, the pressure's on my faith, not on me. The most freeing day in my life was when I figured out I can't change my kids. Only the word can change them. I can't change them. You love them, you pray for them, you want things to go right, you can't change them. And sometimes they go do things that bring hurt into their lives. And you don't want that because you're their parent. But your job is to not go to God and say, oh, Lord, they're messing up. Go to God with the word. What did he say? Put me in remembrance of my word. Come now, let us reason together. And so you take God's word to him. And you take the book of Isaiah. And you say, now, Lord, you said that even the captives of the mighty would be taken prey. And that you would contend with them that contend with me. And you'd save my children. Lord, that's what you said. So I'm just letting you know I'm believing that. I'm putting my faith in that. I believe that's what you're going to do. Pastor, is that how you do it? That's exactly how I do it. I'll walk through my house. And I'll tell God, now, Lord, this is what your word said. And this is what I'm expecting. I don't see it, but this is what I'm expecting to see. Why? God can't lie. He's a man of integrity. This is truth. That settles the issue. Amen. Tell your neighbor, the word is truth. And that settles the issue. Amen. Do you understand that? Now, things are not perfect. They are not as perfect as I would like to see them. But that kid today is married. Amen. I'm going to give me my second grandbaby in 8 months. I'm ahead of you. Amen. Hallelujah. You beat me with kill. He's got numbers on his side. Amen. He's got 4 daughters and a son. Dear Lord. Hallelujah. That's all right. We're little, but we're mighty. Amen. And he's my one of my favorite sons in the Lord, so I can't despise him. And live, what y'all saw in church today, living for the Lord, doing the best she knows how to do. I was able to lead her husband to the Lord. Praise God. Amen. Now, I'm not bragging. I'm saying we learned a long time ago, put your faith in gear and leave it there. Don't take it out of gear. Well, how do I take it out of gear? Well, I don't see anything happening. You just went into neutral. No forward momentum. Well, when are things going to change? Right? And then you, oh, Lord, forgive me. And you'll get back on the work. And now you're in gear again. I'm serious. Put it in gear and don't move it. The hardest thing for people where faith is concerned is quit messing with it. Have you ever told your child that? Leave that alone. Quit messing with that. Richard has to tell Kim that all the time. Will you leave that alone? We have got her where she don't bring 10 bags on a trip now. I think we're down to 8. Amen. Yeah, 6. There you go, 6. But you understand what I'm saying? Leave it alone. Get it moving and leave it alone. Now you're adding to it. I want to help you with this tonight. So whoever is born of God overcometh the world. And this is, here's another word to underline, the victory that overcometh the world. Even our faith. The word even is in italics, so you could say this is the victory that overcomes the world. Our faith. Our faith overcomes the world. You have world overcoming faith. Remember the song we sang today? Jeremy sang it. The mountains shake before you. The demons run and flee. At the mention of your name, King of Majesty, there is no power in hell or any who can stand before the power and the presence of the great I am. Nothing can stand in front of your faith and win. Because faith is the victory that overcomes the world. Now, before we're done tonight, you're going to be able to say that you're going to have this in your mind. Why? God can't lie. That's a law. Faith is a law. So that means whatever you may be challenged to worry about tonight, you cast it over onto your faith, you cast it over onto the Word of God, and you go home and you go to sleep and you sleep like a baby. Why? Faith's working on it. Well, you're sleeping, faith is working. Now listen, if you set up worrying about it, faith stops working. Why? Listen to me, because now you've entered into the law of works. And when you enter into the law of works, the law of faith quits working. Because it only engages when you stop and let it start. If you're going to worry about it, faith takes the responsibility, you take the responsibility away from faith. Amen. Okay, remember Brother Hagin carrying his son in one arm and his daughter in another arm, and he's fumbling with the keys, he's trying to unlock the door. And Miss Aretha said, they were going through something, and she said, "Wow, if me and these kids both just died, you wouldn't worry about it." He said, "Well, no, why would I worry then? You'd be dead." Now, I'm not telling you to say that. And he wasn't being ugly. He was just saying, well, yeah, exactly. Why would I worry then? It'd be over with. Can I tell you two things? You've never worried anything into your life, and anything you've ever worried about has never happened. By and large, it's never come to pass. The enemy's tried. There are people under the sound of my voice. The enemy's tried to get you to worry that you're not going to make it financially. And here you are. You're still here. You're still paying the bills. You're still making it. Everything's still okay. Right? And what you worry about just moves farther away from you. And here's why. Faith is the receiver. Faith is the attractor. Faith is the bringer of the things of God into your life. And when you choose to worry about it, you stop faith from working and you repel what you're trying to get. See, got to go home, go to sleep. You got to cast the care over on the Word and go to sleep. Why? Because the Bible says in the book of Psalms, it's vain for you to sit up all night and worry. You know what vain means? It literally means empty-headed. But I'm not going to say that. It means it makes no sense for you to sit up all night and worry. Because he said, unless the Lord build the house, they labor in vain that build it. Right? So you can labor all you want and it's in vain. Glory to God. Say out loud, my faith is working.
My faith is working.
See, faith is the victory that overcomes the world. Here's something you got to learn. Faith does not produce victory. Faith is the victory. It doesn't produce victory. It is the victory. Well, I'm believing my faith's going to produce victory. No, faith is victory. If you got faith, you've got victory. Of what? Well, read the word again. The world. Anything connected with fallen world, you've got victory over it. That's why you can say by faith that it doesn't matter to you what happens in the economy. You're safe and secure. Your finances are safe and secure. Yeah, but you know, I got one of them jobs. One of them what kind of jobs? See, we're about to find out what you're developing. Amen. Well, you know, I got a government job. How does that matter? Daniel had a government job with one of the most wicked kings the world's ever known, and he prospered. They couldn't do without him. Why don't you go to your job every day and say, they can't do without me? Amen. When you walk in, sit down at your desk, say, praise God, they're glad I'm here. There's going to be so much money roll into this place today because of me. They might fire everybody else, but they're not going to fire me because they need me. I'm their number one provider. I'm their number one salesman. I'm their number one whatever you are. I'm the number one. Amen. It's your choice. You can be number one or number two or number three or number four, whichever one you want to be. Amen. The law of faith will produce. Look at Matthew 17. Are you receiving from this tonight? Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. And the time will go on and on. And the time will go on and on. And you'll look and you'll say, when is it going to arrive? Well, I'm to tell you tonight, the Lord says, that the package has been wrapped. It's been sent your way. Faith is bringing it to you, maybe even today. Tomorrow, expect it. It's sure to arrive. And when it does, you'll rejoice and not cry. Because the contents inside are bigger, you see, than anything that you've ever dreamed. You've been believing for a certain thing, but I've added extra, a bonus, if you will. Oh, yes. And it's going to be more than enough to supply all you need. It'll bless you, give you seed, make you prosperous. Yes, indeed. More and more is coming your way. Keep your faith on the line. It might be today. You can't ever tell when it might just show up. The knock will come on the door, and there it will be. And you'll say, Lord, when did this arrive? Well, it's been on its way all this time. So get ready. Get ready to shout. Get ready to rejoice. Get ready to dance a jig, because I'm bringing you a present, and it's going to be big. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. Oh, glory to God. Oh, glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. 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 Now, you're standing up there. Listen to me. You're standing up there, and you need to hear what I'm about to say to you, because the Lord said, I saw you sow that car, and I haven't forgotten about it. And you put everybody else's Snickers behind you, and you put their thoughts behind you, and you get ready. Start looking. Start looking, because I want to bring it to you. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Oh, glory. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, glory. Oh, glory. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Lord. Ha, ha, ha. Ha, ha, ha. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hmm. Okay, yeah. Hallelujah. That's not all. There's some more there. Praise the Lord. So, don't overthink it. It's easy, you see. Yes, just as easy as ABC. You put it on paper and it doesn't make sense. You write down a list and it doesn't make sense. Well, take out your faith and use it like a wrench. Take out your faith and apply it today. Take out your faith, it'll make a way. Don't overthink it. It'll just get bigger. Get out of your head. Get over in the spirit. In the spirit realm, faith makes sense. It makes perfect sense. So those things that have been held back, those things that have not yet appeared, they shall appear quickly, and they shall appear suddenly. And you will again declare, the Lord has been good to me and blessed me indeed. So prepare, get yourself ready, make room. Not just a little corner in a room. Clear out a room. Clear out a space that I can bring things that I am sending you from my love and my grace in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. I receive that, Lord. I receive that, Lord. Glory, 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 glory. Glory, 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 glory. Glory. Get me a container. A container. Glory, 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 glory. Two of them. Two of them. Glory, 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 glory. Glory, 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 glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Faith is a law. Faith is a law. Faith is a law. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I have found your spirit pure and your heart clean. Everything you've ever asked me for is to be a blessing to somebody else. And I've blessed you to an extent, and you've helped bless others. But there's something coming into your life, and I want you to use it on you. I want you to bless yourself. I'm going to bring it into your life, and you're going to know what it is. And when it comes into your life, use it on those desires that you've been seeing and wanting, because I want you blessed as much as you've been a blessing to others. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. 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 Hallelujah. 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 Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 And even the needs will be met. Yeah, you've even thought at times, what about college? What about school? That's something I think I would like. Well, right now, at this stage in your life, roll it on to me. I'll make a way, and I'll send you to the school. It'll make your day. I'll give you a good car, a pretty one too. It'll all be clean. I've got it ready for you. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. 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 If you think, the two of you, that you've seen raises and bonuses up till now, you've been faithful in first fruits and sowed them, oh how, that's about to come into your life in wave after wave, a torrential downpour of finances coming your way. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And I brought you out, the Lord says, of a physical thing. And I showed you that I could make a way where there seems to be none. Now I'm going to take you to another level of life, a level of victory that you've never seen. Oh, there'll be money and there'll be victory in that financial arena, but there'll be influence that you've never had. You will influence people with the gospel of Jesus Christ. Keep your heart pure and your mind right. I'm going to use your life and I'm going to bless you out of sight. Hallelujah. Glory to God. 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 Hallelujah. 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 Oh, glory. Yeah, the seeing eye and the hearing ear too. I made them both, and victory's coming to you. Keep declaring my word. That hearing will clear up. You'll begin to hear clearer and you'll begin to hear more direct. It's coming, it's coming. Don't give up. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. 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 Now we're going to sow tonight. If you'd like to get involved in this, just I'm going to keep moving as the Holy Spirit leads me. Hallelujah. 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 Glory to God. 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 Glory. Ha 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 ha. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Ha 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 ha. Come here, Michelle. Hallelujah. I'm going to bless you on your job. I'm going to bless you where you work. That's not going to be your source. I'm going to open up the windows. I'm going to pour it out even more and more. There are things I'm going to ask you to do. Don't blink an eye. I'll make a way, and you'll see they're all going to come to pass in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. Come here. Come here. Let me pray for you. Come here. Let me pray for you. You keep being sure. You keep being true. Keep doing what I ask you to do. You've stayed sure and steadfast. You've kept your witness intact. I'm going to bless you, bless you, bless you. Don't ever look back. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. Ah, ha, 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 ha. Ho, 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 ho. Holy Ghost. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Oh, glory. In the spirit again. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Oh, glory. I don't understand all that. They saw you come in here. You're part of us. Just join in. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Ha, 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 ha. Ha, 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 ha. I need a real quick count on that. I need a real quick count on that. Get somebody to help you. Hallelujah. And it may not apply to everybody, but if you want a dose of joy, just stand up. Just stand on up. Hallelujah. Come on, just get ready to receive it. Get ready to receive it. There it is. There it is. There it is. Glory to God. Joy! 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 Joy in your spirit. Joy in your heart. Joy in Jesus' name. Hey, there's that joy. There's that joy. Hallelujah. 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 Matter of fact, it's right here. Just reach over there and touch that person next to you. Just lay hands on them. Tell them, be joyful. Be joyful. Hallelujah. Oh, glory. Oh, glory. Oh, glory. Ha, 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 ha. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, glory. Thank you, Jesus. Woo! Oh, glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So ramamarabase. Oh, glory. Glory, 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 glory. Shh. Woo. Oh, glory. Hallelujah. Oh, glory. You know, it hadn't changed. This is that spoken by the prophet Joel. In the last days, I'll pour out of my spirit on all flesh. And your sons and your daughters will prophesy. Your old men will dream dreams. Your young men will see visions. Upon my servants and upon my handmaidens, I'll pour out of my spirit. Glory to God. Just be refilled. Just be refilled with the Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to Oh, glory. Zema. Ho. That's it. Ho, glory. Se ra ma 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 re bre ge de be re bre se. Ha. Glory. So ra ma 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 re bre se ke te po ro bro go ye. Re me ne ma ha ha ha. So na ma re bre se. Yeah. Ho re be be re re bo so ko to re bre se ke. Shora mama re 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 be de 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 be se ke re bosa re mana mara bra sa ra ba sa ra ra ba ha. Oh glory. Shora mama mama. Hallelujah. Hey, Brother Charles, come here. Hold out your hand. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. Oh, glory. Glory. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So ramama yada. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Woo! God is good. Hallelujah. 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 Glory to God. Oh, glory. I'm here to tell you, it only takes God a second. Amen. Hallelujah. And I'm also going to tell you, I know why you'll always be blessed, because you rejoice like that when somebody gets blessed. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory! Glory! Hallelujah! Oh, glory. Oh, glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. My Lord. My Lord, my Lord, my Lord, my Lord. Where do you stop? Where do you get off this thing? Amen. Hallelujah. 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 Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Lord, we're grateful. Thankful to you tonight, Lord. Thank you so much. Lord, we want to return the honor due your name. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. We're grateful. Lord, I'm grateful. Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Zohora ma marege de bosore besina maroke senhene. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. hinge on this presence that we have. But I do, if we're just, we're going to be dismissed in just a moment, so we can just, if we can stay where we're at. I don't know how this applies to everybody or if it applies to everyone, but I know obviously the presence of the Lord is with us every time we're here. But there are those moments of visitation where Jesus comes. Now, I don't have to see him. I just know. And the book of Revelation says that Jesus is consistently visiting his church. Seven churches of Asia Minor. He went to every one of those churches. He visited them. He said, I've been there. I've walked in the aisles. Now, he said to one of those churches, he said to the church at Ephesus, he made this statement. He said, it was a good church. He said, but I have just a thing against you. King James says somewhat. And he said, here's what it is. You've left your first love. Amen. Now, I'm saying that for a reason. I don't know who all it affected, but two things have happened tonight in these moments. Number one, there are many people in here, your mind got cleared up. I'm telling you, your mind is going to be clearer than you've ever thought it could be. Those thoughts that have plagued you for a long time, they're gone. And I mean that, they're gone. Secondly, there are people during the time that we were on our knees in the presence of the Lord, your first love was rekindled. The fire started again. Keep it going. Keep it going. Because God is going to do some miraculous things here. I believe that. Amen. So I don't know everything he did, but I know he worked on me. I know he worked on you. Hallelujah. I believe God. I believe God. Amen. And I know usually we will go over our vision, but I don't want to do that tonight. I don't want to impinge on this presence. I know that we need to go home, and that's fine. We should. But, you know, let's just go home in this presence. Let's just go home in this presence. And I always encourage people, you know, when you go home in this presence, don't just fall in the trap and turn the radio on. You know, if you listen to something you're going to worship. You're going to keep this presence, nursing it along, because you'll go home with it tonight, and it'll invade your house, and there'll be a residue in the morning. Amen? I believe that. I know that. I know that from experience. And when we show up here for school tomorrow night, it'll be waiting on us. Amen? So I believe God. Amen? Amen. We love you. God bless you. Thank you for being here tonight. Praise God.